Hi, good morning. This is Abhay from Arun Patra Information Solutions. So I was speaking before also. It's okay. Let me start. So thank you for joining me for this orientation session on Manu Patra. So this we are organizing just for MIT school students. It's been a difficult few days for all of us. Thank you. You have been Credit goes to you guys that you have been using this time to learn new skills, to learn new things. So let me begin with a brief introduction with Manu Patra Information Solutions. So Manu Patra started a journey in the year 2000 as the pioneers of online legal search in India. So since then, we have grown into the largest content aggregator for both Indian and international database. What has helped us stay relevant for the 20 years, apart from a loyal clientele who has been with us for 20 years, is our dedication towards technology. So we see ourselves as a technology company in a publishing industry. So you use Manu Patra in the front end. There's a lot of things that go in the back end that we use technologies like artificial intelligence, natural language processing, visualization tools, editorial inputs at the right place, so that you are able to see a pattern in the sea of data that is available everywhere these days. So a lot of thought goes into how to make it more easier, how to make it simpler, how to make it faster for our user to get to the most relevant judgment in the least possible time. So that is the main focus of the company. With that, let's start with the demo. So now this will be our home screen. So we are assuming that you've used Manu Patra before. You have somewhat knowledge about this. And I'll show you like the important features for this one, like which are the important ones. And after that, we can go to the questions. In the meanwhile, also, I'll just keep asking you questions. I'll keep tick two, three queries. And if there are any questions, you can just always ask me in the text. Okay. So this is username password. So either you have a username password to get into the portal or you have an IP subscription. So when you're connected to your college Wi-Fi, there will be a button available here for the IP access user here to click onto that button and you will be able to get into the portal. Okay. So now this is my home screen. On the left-hand side, there are different searches. Manu search is there, legal search, citation search. And on the right-hand side, this is the table of contents. So table of contents in Manu Patra has two major uses. One is it'll show you where a particular document is located in Manu Patra server. So in notification circulars are located here. Another one is if you're looking for a Supreme Court judgment, say, so you can just select Supreme Court here, and then you can go on to make your search. So that way it will only look in the Supreme Court judgments only. Similarly, for any High Court or Tribunal judgment you want specifically an NCLT judgment, you can always come here and check the box. Okay, so let me quickly go through the table of content, then we can go back to the search engine. Okay, so this is Supreme Court. So for Supreme Court, we cover all the judgments from inception, so from 1950 till today. Similarly, for Supreme Court orders from 1980 till today, all the orders you will be able to see. For high courts, all the 24 high courts are covered comprehensively from inception. So I'll show you for once, say Calcutta High Court. This is the oldest court in India. So from 1860 till today, all the judgments are available for the Calcutta High Court. Again, for the Privy Councils, so these are the federal courts, Lahore court. So these are the courts that were pre-independence. So from 1850 onwards till today, all the judgments that these have been covering. So very comprehensive coverage you will get with Manu Patra. Similarly, for tribunals and commissions. So for tribunals and commissions, we have 40 tribunals and commissions. So all the major ones we cover. So all NCLT, DRT, ITAT, all these benches you will be able to see. I'll show you for once. NCLT is very popular these days. So you can just see from here, all the benches are available. New Delhi bench. If you're just looking for a New Delhi bench judgment, you can just select on this one. So the coverage for tribunals is very, very good with Manu Patra. Again, international database. So these we cover Commonwealth English-speaking countries plus US and UK. Okay. So Supreme Court decisions from all these countries is available. Say I'll show you for Supreme Court. So for Supreme Court, from it For Supreme Court of United States, it goes from 1750 till today. All the decisions are available. So in Manu Patra, you have this option of searching both the international and national judgments in the same portal. So if you're searching for, say, right to privacy, that is as much as a global issue as it is a national issue. So you can just go through these. International Court of Justice is also there. Okay, business policy. Now, what do we have in business policy is very interesting, that on a particular subject of law, you will be able to find all the secondary and primary database in one folder. Now, what do I mean by secondary and primary database? So the primary database is the acts, the rules, forms, everything that is coming directly from the authority. The secondary database is committee reports, annual reports. So what I'm saying is anything related to my field is available to me in one folder. So suppose I'm a corporate lawyer, so everything is available. So if I need to check what all notification has been coming, what all reports has been coming, so I can just click here and see from here. So 2020, these are the similarly due dates and penalties according to companies law 2013. So all these due diligence part is also covered in Manu Patra. So often Manu Patra is seem like we have the judgments, but we have a lot more apart from the judgments. So this is very much used by the corporate. So whenever you get to go on an internship in a corporate or join as a corporate lawyer, this will be a very helpful tool in your arsenal. Okay, the next one is corporate law and taxation. Similarly, the same table is available for, say, GST. GST is an evolving law. New committee reports or new press releases keep on coming. So what do I do if I need to get myself updated? So everything related to my subject is available to me in one folder. Okay, let's go to the next one, notification circulars. You might be aware that different ministries, state as well as central, ask their notifications. So we are the only one that are covering state notifications. All these you will be able to see from here. Say, I want to open one, say Ministry of Health, these days more active. So 2020, so all these notifications you will be able to see. Click on any one. So this is how it will look in Manu Patra. So again, I'll bring your notice to this small feature, but very, very helpful. So anything in Manu Patra is comprehensively cross-referenced. So Section 10A, if it's being mentioned here, that is linked to the Section 10A. So Drugs and Cosmetics Act, Section 10A, you will be able to read. If you want to read the judgments on the same, you can also see from here. So similarly, if it has been referred, some other notification has also been referred in this one, you can also see that. If you want to take out a PDF, mail it to somebody, all that is available, gadget copy is available. So this is as it is appearing on their website. So what happens is when you're looking for a notification, you have to go to 10 different sites. There might be some small link somewhere. So here everything is available to you in one go. You just have to go to these folders, just expand onto these one, and once you see a hyperlink, you'll be able to open that particular folder. So this is for notification circulars. And let's move on to the next one. Bare Acts, again, very, very crucial for any legal person. So this is central as well as states, rules and regulations are also there. So open this folder. You have to open these by just clicking onto this plus sign. Okay, just click onto the plus sign. When you see a table of like a hyperlink here, you can click on that one. Okay, so once I have clicked on this one, so here I'll be given option if I want to see the Bare Acts chronological wise, alphabetical, subject wise. Say I am choosing for now alphabetical. So A, B, C, D, all are available. Let me click on all. So this is all the Bare Acts, central Bare Acts for me in one folder. Okay, so this is the main act. So Aadhaar Act 2016, this is the amendment. So the 2016 one will have 2019 amendment automatically. Okay, so this will be the main act and we put amendments separately. Okay, so this is the pattern throughout. Open one, say Consumer Protection Act. So I'm showing this because of this small feature which is very helpful. This is a flag. So 2019, the act has been passed, everything is, but it's not been notified yet. This is a small information that you need to keep in mind when you are preparing for a moot or going to court. So 2019, this is yet to be notified. So that information we are giving. So for any act, so open any, next time you open Manupatra, you can go to any act of your choice. You can just see these features for that. So 1986. So these are on the left hand side, different buttons that are available for any act. Say I want to view this in single document. So this will be available to me in a single document. Now I can always click on commentary if I want to read the commentary on the same. So commentary is also available. So both the primary and secondary is available. Anything that is being passed through a notification or a act that has been hyperlinked. So you can always click on to that one and it will take you to the act also. So this is how do you see that the particular act in one particular folder. So this can be done from here. Annotations. So if you want to read some annotations on the same act, comparative chart. This is again very important. So how is my Consumer Protection Act 1986 different from the 2019 one? Which section is what now? So there's a lot of confusion. Sometimes you just remember the section. Sometimes you just remember the. So just to clarify that, you can come here and compare like which is what now. So this is 21F was defect. Now subsection 10 is defect. Okay. So this was one. Rules and regulations is again there for any Bare Act. Rules and regulations are also provided. So both the Bare Act also will be able to see rules and regulations. This is in vernacular, Hindi, English, Marathi. Okay. Let's click on to this one. So once you are finished with these features, you can always come here and click on to this one also. This is also a hyperlink. This gives me section wise. So section 1, section 2, section 3, whichever section I want to read. So I want to read section 8. So I can click on section 8. It will ask me whether I want to read the act or the commentary. I want to read the act. Okay. So this will be section 8 for Consumer Protection Act. I can say I want to read section 5 also from here. Section 5 is also available. Commentary is available. Judgments, top judgments on from Supreme Court is available from just one click away. So I can also read judgments on this. If you want to do a full search on a particular judgment, that is also available from here. So I want to search judgments on section 8. I can click on to this blue button. So you can click here and you will be able to see all the judgments from section 8. So this is a very common question. How do we make a search from, you know, just a section? So this is what you can also do. There's another way also that I'll come when we come to that. Okay. So the idea here is that you go back whenever you open Manupatra next time, just open one Bare Act and see all these features and everything will come back to you. So, you know, just everything is available here. Just click on the different buttons and automatically you'll be able to revive this information. Okay. And next, state Bare Acts are also there. Rules and regulations are also there. So very comprehensive. So rules and regulations also, we get a lot of query from clients, you know, that I want this particular rule, state's rules, that all we are covering. Again, committee reports, court fees, rules, say committee reports on different subjects, non-government bodies or government parties keep coming up with their recommendations. So if you're doing some essay of some kind or any research, this will again be very helpful. So human rights, all the committee reports that have been coming. Apart from that, there is constituent assembly debates. So these are also very much favored by advocates. So if you want to go back to 1950 and see what happened there, you can always come here. Again, court fees, court rules, court forms, these are all available. If you're going for an internship, you are asked to prepare a draft. So we have given all the formats here. So this will be available in the both the Word and PDF. You can click anyone, say trademark. And if you want to download this, you can just click onto the Word button and it will be downloaded. And forms are there, miscellaneous. Miscellaneous is, say, district court cases, which we don't usually cover. We cover Supreme Court and High Courts only, but still these are coming in media these days. So that are also available and you can come here and see Salman Khan made this is. So all these district court cases are also there, which are doing their rounds in media. Now extradition treaties with different country, budget is there. So budget is uploaded the same day, railway and union budget. So if you want to get from an authenticated source, not from like internet, you can just come here and download the budget also. This is ebooks. So different ebooks are available. So client called the other day asking for this because he's been stuck in some place. So this is available. All the section wise, you can just read one, say preliminary, and now you can always download this. So you can always able to access it without the internet also. So these ebooks on different subjects are available from here. Again, academic ebooks are there. Academic ebooks are like the regular ebooks, but the only difference is that there is hyperlinking. So any case that is mentioned, that will be linked to the case law, or any section is mentioned is the judgment or the act, and then come back to the book. So this is possible through technology. Academic ebooks, articles are there. So many students also, professionals keep sending us articles. Now we are getting a lot of requests for COVID articles people are sending us. So all these are available. You can search from here. You can give a topic, say banking, and you can hear a publication from here. So this is available, thousands of articles. If you just want to see the articles, you can just come here to be able to see. Next one is the legal taxonomy. So legal taxonomy is like a digest. So what we have tried to do here is mimic your book. So your book has a topic, it has a different subtopics on that. So you can just click onto these subtopics. And the idea is at the end of these, you will get judgments. Okay, so you keep going deeper into these subtopics. From here, you'll be able to see all the relevant judgments. So the idea is you don't even have to go to manual search, legal search. Just come here, and from legal taxonomy, you'll be able to access the subject or sub-subject wise. Okay, so this is for the table of contents part. Let's come to the more exciting part of the demo, which is the search part. So this is what we are known for in the industry. So this is the heart of Manupatra, Manu Search. We go to client, they've been using it for 20 years. This is their favorite search. So now the best part about the search is that you don't have to think much. So there are a lot of search engines which uses a lot of complex formulas. We also have them if you want to need that. But if you just say types anything, say order 7, rule 11A, and you just type it out here. Making my search. So automatically it will fetch judgment for order 7, rule 11A is coming. Okay. So not only that, it's already taking it as a phrase. So it's not possible in most of the other search engines. So everything is available here, and it's very simple to search in Manu Search. That is our main source of bread and butter. So let's do this. So there is another query I can do, say gender justice. So this is again a topic-based query. Whichever judgments related to gender justice, Vishaka is there, and the number one judgments. It is in a matter of half a second, it has fetched me 6,007 results. Okay, so yesterday I was on YouTube, I was seeing this lecture by Menika Goswami ma'am and Arundhati Karjuma, the counsels for the famous case in 2018 for gay rights. So I was very much inspired by that. I recommend that. That is available in YouTube, Oxford Union. So Menika Gandhi, just type and it will pop up. Very much interesting. So I'll just use that query, say LGBT rights. So this will give me judgments for whatever reports have been coming. The first one is a report on LGBT. There have been 4 judgments by Supreme Court on this topic. So this question is a very common query by students, by legal practitioners. How do I know the judgment is overruled? So there is a 2013 judgment. You might be aware, you might not be aware, that this was overruled by the 2018 judgment. So now this overruled judgment in Manupatra has this plaque. So this is the acid test. So any judgment which has this plaque means that judgment has been overruled by some other judgment. Okay, if it doesn't have that, okay, none of these have. So these are not overruled. So just look out for this red flag. Check if the judgment has been overruled. It might be, have been dissented in some other case, but not overruled. This is case, if it's overruled, then this will have a flag here. Okay. Now, another thing that we have introduced recently is SLP. So SLP is again something that you might, this is very, very helpful, very much people were asking for it. So this is like if a high court case and SLP is filed for that in the Supreme Court. So till the time it's pending, it's, even this is dangerous for me. If it's disposed of or it's been assigned, so then I know, but a pending SLP, I need to know. So this is available here. So before opening the judgment, this is the button to open the judgment. These options, small, small icons are available. So just, you know, be mindful of these and these will help you incredibly with your legal search. So I'll open this one. And let me go to navigate. You can use this. I'll just go to the top and go to the SLP. The last to 56 plus. Okay, 50 plus 1, 51. Now these are the pending SLPs with the number. Click on to this one. This might give me the order as well. No order available, but the pending SLP is with this number. So very, very helpful tool, very, very small tool that will help your legal search. Okay. Now another thing that is there in Manu search that is not there anywhere, like we are used to searching in Google, so we have just one search bar. So in Manu search there is this option of search and results, so you can always refine your results. So this is a layman mistake, or you know, very senior people also do tend to do this, that they tend to write their entire query in one go. Okay, so that time the system gets confused. So you can always start with a broader topic and refine it. So I've found 152 judgments from LGBT. Now I can come to say equal rights. I've put it in inverted commas. So inverted commas means that this will search this particular equal right in a phrase. So wherever, in whichever judgment equal rights are coming together, it will only look for those judgments among this 152. This is the radio button. Okay, so these are like, now I have come down to 62 some results. So there's always an option to search in results, so you can always keep on refining your search. You know, start from the broad terms that you know, you can always narrow down to the details of your particular case. So that way it's much better. Let's cross this one. Okay, so from here we have learned that how to do a basic keyword and how to refine the results and cover table of contents. Now I'd like to take some questions if you have any questions from the topic that we had covered, then we'll do a proper case study. Okay. Ankita ma'am has asked, how can we get national updated? So I don't know, national, is it talking about judgment? So we update them on the site, so that is updated automatically. Or if you're talking about the Bayer Act, then the amendment, as soon as the amendment is coming, we are amending it on the Bayer Act. Okay. Okay. So no questions till now. I'll come back again looking for them. Okay, so this is our query. So this is a small query that we have prepared for you. You can just, give you 1 minute and you can go through it. Okay, so my client, Ms. Reena James, who seeks compassionate appointment in place of her father, a government servant dying in harness. Her plea was rejected on the ground that dying in harness rules 1974 does not allow divorced daughters as family. So what we have to do is find relevant case laws to help us. So what I want you to do is from this query, this is the kind of query that you will get in your normal when you are searching in Manupatra. So this will look like that. So what I want to do is just focus on what is your keyword here. You know, just blur everything out and what's you're looking for. See, compassionate appointment is one. So this is a case-based compassionate appointment, and we are looking for compassionate appointment for divorced daughters. Okay, it should be daughter. So let's go on Manu search and type our query. Say compassionate appointment for divorce. Okay, so these are my some results. If I say divorced and make my search. Okay, so these are some of the judgments that 5 and 10 results I found out from here. Click on to this one. This is if you want to read the head note of the judgment. So this is available from here. So this is a Patna High Court judgment. So this will give me a brief synopsis of the editorial things that we are putting in, the name of the judgment, citing references, there's citing references which were discussed in this case, which cases were mentioned. So all the citing cases, what was the treatment given to them? The case note is held in every case of the death of the government servant in harness, it may not be possible to appoint. There was no wasted right. Okay, so here she has been denied compassionate appointment in the first case. Now let me click on to the second one. So this is Allahabad High Court judgment 2001. This gives me dependent upon her father, continue to be the liability of her father has to be included within the meaning of the word family. So here she has been granted the compassionate appointment for her father. So this is my case. This is an Allahabad High Court case. Now to open the judgment, the usual mistake is just click on this one and this will open this in the same window. If I want to open it in a new window, there's an option available here, open this document in a new window. So that is always more suggested. Just click on to this one. Okay, around 12 in the daytime, my internet crashes. This has been a pattern for a few days. Check for Google. If you have any questions, we can take that. Okay, so we are covering that, how to show a particular case. Supreme Court. Okay. Ankitanshu, I'll come to that. I'll show you a Supreme Court judgment. Okay. So let's come to Kusum Levy for now. Okay, so let's go to Manu and other questions that you might have, you can take them first because net 2 minutes it will take. Any more questions or should I show filters from here? Okay, so this is filters. So different filters are also available. Okay, it's gone. So if something like this happens and you've gone, like your search is gone, you can always come here. Search history is there and you can, your last search will be, last 10-20 searches will be here. You can just click on to this button and this will take me to the MATLAB previous search. Okay, so let me open this from here. So this is my judgment, Allahabad High Court judgment. From here, I will also be able to see that it has been cited in 6 cases. Okay. To open this, you have to click here. and let's open this one. Okay, so I want to see this. This is a very old judgment, 2001. So I want more recent cases. So there is this pattern that I'll show you, just this one. So this is cited in para. So what cited in para does for you is it gives me the list of judgments where this particular judgment has been referred, and it also gives me the paragraphs of that judgment. So it has been cited in 6 judgments. And this is Allahabad High Court judgment. Recently, 2019 came out. Another judgment came out in March 2019, Allahabad High Court judgment, which is quoted the judgment. So these are the 6 judgments that I probably want to go through, you know, because this has been quoting this case. These will be helpful. So from there, you started from one particular judgment and you have found 6-7. So that is how you find new cases related to your topic. Let's come to the other. Okay, let's come back. I'll show you one small thing more from here. Search history. So there are these radio buttons that are available in Manupatra. So this is search and result. This we have refined. How to refine your search? This is near each other. So what near each other does for you is it gives a range where these 4 words are coming. So it will search within 20 words. So this is basically a proximity search. Okay. So now it's looking for all those 4 words in a range of 20 words. So the idea is you don't have to frame a query. No, you just have to type the keyword. So like these are my 4 keywords that I'm looking in the judgment. Do nothing. Just write your keywords and select near each other from here and make your search. Okay. So automatically the system will look for whichever judgments this has been done. These are there in a range of 20 words. So now I'm getting just 37 results from here. So more accurate way to search. Okay. So this is Manu search. Now let's come to assisted search. Okay. So assisted search is very much similar to Manu search. So here we have given it a tagline, Boolean search made easy. So very self-explanatory. So form is available in front of you. So, you know, I want to search dowry death. So I want this in inverted commas. So I'm putting it exactly this phrase. So dowry death, wherever it is coming as a phrase. Okay. So similarly, if you're looking for some other phrase, you can put here. If you're looking, say, for some words also, say, I'm looking for dying. Declaration, and I can just put a range. I want this there. The proximity was 20. Now here I can say 10. I just take 10. So in whichever judgments they are, dying declaration is coming in a proximity of 10 words. It'll take all those results. So very simple, very easy to use. No formulas, nothing. I can always eliminate certain. So there are like 821 results. I can always remove some of these. Say there was no eyewitness, so I just want, I don't want to witness it. So I can just search. So all those judgments where witness was coming, that has been removed. So this is a very easy way to search Boolean. Just go to assisted search and from here. Again, filtration is there. Say Supreme Court judgments, 18 of these judgments are Supreme Court. This is just to narrow down your search. You know, you don't know what to search next. These are the suggestions that we are giving to you. Out of these, appeal against acquittal, 2 judgments are on that. So these are just some suggestions that are available. Different judges. So say you're given this query, A.K. Ganguly, sir, in 2009 gave this judgment. Find that out for me. So how do you do that? Just click search name and you will be able to get those judgments. Okay. Similarly, period wise is also there, 2010 2019. So if you want to see the recent cases also, you can see, and if you want to see like last year cases or this year cases, that also you'll be able to see. Document type, articles, case laws, all these are available. Judge bench wise, if you want to see a decision, no, higher bench first. So that there's a one decision. there. Okay. So this was assisted search. So we have covered Manu, we have covered assisted. Now we'll quickly cover legal and citation. And I'll just show you a judgment also from a Supreme Court judgment, as ma'am said, will be there. So if there's any query, okay. Voice is echoing. Okay. Any there now? Perfect. Okay. Let's come to the next legal search. Okay, now we are here. So legal search, this is again a very common question, how Manu search is different from legal search. So legal search is when you have a particular section, particular party name in mind. So say in Manu search, you are starting your search with keywords. You know, these are the 4 or 5 keywords that I'm looking for in a judgment. In legal search, you are starting your search with a section. You know, I have just NI-138. I want judgments on NI-138, I can always filter from these results. So NI-138. So these are all the judgments, 14,000 sub judgments on NI-138. I can cite them in decision date. I want the latest ones on these on 138. I can also select cited most. So all the cited most cases will also load. Manu Instant is available from, okay, Manu Instant is there. You can just click see all. So these are basically the case notes, the acts. So all the first 10 judgments, you will be able to see the case notes and everything. You can take out a printout from here as well. So you are preparing for a moot. You are handing it to a colleague. So you can just take out the judgments, top 10 judgments that you found from here. That is available. Okay. So this is, these are some of the judgments. This has been cited 841 times. This has been cited 625 times. K. Bhaskaran is overruled case. So this flag is there. To open any, say, let's open any judgment, Supreme Court judgment, open this one. So this is how it's looking on Manupatra. So most of the search engine, your search ends when you are getting to the judgment. So now you just take out a printout and go to the court. In Manu, what we do is like the search begins from, like some of it always is left from here. So this is, everything is hyperlinked. So, you know, any high court case, any Bear Act, any notification, any report, anything that is being mentioned in this one will be hyperlinked to the case. You can click onto the hyperlink and you will be easily able to navigate between these two. Okay. Similarly, sections are also hyperlinked. Click on anyone and you will be able to read these sections also. Another one small, very helpful tool is just double click on any word and it will give you the dictionary meaning of that word. Okay, so I have selected interpretational. So this meaning is available from here. So double click on any word or any legal exam is also there. You'll be able to directly without going outside. Just double click on the word and it will pop this option of no more. Okay, so comprehensively hyperlink, control C plus, no copy paste, drafting is very easy. You can just copy and paste to the document. This case note is available in all the judgments. Disposition is there, so in favor of accused. Now the prior history also we get. So it was the earlier, this case was in Delhi High Court. So that judgment also we have mentioned here. So everything related to that case, you will be able to find this template. So whenever we go to a client, we show this, we find this very good. So this is citing reference. Now what is citing reference? Citing reference is, these are the cases that have been referred in this case, these number of cases. Now out of these cases, how many cases were discussed, how many were dissented, how many were relied on. So it gives me the treatment that were given to these cases. So if this, what we call in our technical language is backward linking. So backward linking is available for all the cases. So if you found this one relevant, you can always go on to this one, this case, which it relied on. So, and if you want case where it was dissented, so there were some cases with which it descended also. So this is available, this is hyperlinked, these are the acts that were used, subject words, banking. So mentioned in gives me all the judgment where this was a 2012 judgment, after which where it was mentioned. Okay, so criminal subject is also given by our team. When legal team does this, we have a 100 to 150 people that are working on this one. Okay, let's come to the citation. This is Manu citation. Once you click on to this one, this will give me the equivalent citation. So SEC, AIR, DLT, all these citations are available from volume 1 till today. So more than 325 journals we cover. So all these journals are available in front of you. Okay, so any judgment have these few buttons that are these are like probably the most important. So like if you see the commentary, you want to see the commentary on this one, if there's a commentary you can see from here. Okay, that we can see. Next one is important para. Now sometimes I don't want to read the entire judgment. This is 2012 judgment. So that way, what important para does for you is it gives you the key paragraph. So how do we define a key paragraph in a judgment? So 31 is a key paragraph because it has been quoted in future in two other judgments. So one judgment is K.S. Puttaswamy, the landmark judgment in 2018, and another one is one in the state of Karnataka versus state of Tamil Nadu. Okay, so this is, they've copy pasted this paragraph from into this judgment. So from here, I'll get a list of all those paragraphs which are quoteworthy in this judgment. Okay, so these are basically the law points from the judgment. So the entire list is available. I can just read these paragraphs first, and I find this one interesting. So this is the paragraph I was looking. So now I can always come to this case and I can read from here. So I've gotten few cases relevant to my point and few other citations that I can read. So very easily that you can do from here. So this is important para. Now another one is cited in para. So this judgment came in 2012. Again, a very common query is where was this cited? So this has been cited 303 times. Recently, a Karnataka High Court judgment, 28th February, has quoted this in this paragraph. Okay. Another Karnataka High Court judgment has quoted this. So where it was quoted and in which paragraph it was being quoted. So that you will be able to see from here. You know, if you find the paragraph important, you can always come here and read the judgment. So wherever it was mentioned and whichever paragraph. Now coming to the next one, this is case map. So case map is again very much interesting. So this is basically gives me all 20 cases which are most relevant to my case. So this is Anita Handa versus Godfather Travels. So let's take this as a timeline. 2012. These are the cases that come prior to. These are the backward linked cases. So there's one case which it dissented. Anita Handa dissented with this case. Another case where it was discussed. This case was discussed in Anita Handa. So these are the previous cases from 2012. Okay. Now what happened to Anita Handa after 2012? So another case came in 2016 which relied on this. Okay. So another came in 2014 which discussed this. Another K. Puttaswamy landmark case, this has mentioned, you know, Anita. So all these judgments I'll be able to see from here. Another judgment is which got affirmed in this judgment. Okay, another thing that you will be able to appreciate from here is it will give you cross references also. So these two cases were also relied on or affirmed in this case. Okay, now it doesn't stop here. You can just click on any one. Say this is a 2015 judgment. I can click on this one and it will give me where now Sunil Bharti is my center of the solar system. Now where Sunil Bharti was, where it was affirmed, where it was mentioned. So I can follow Sunil Bharti. I want to go to the next case, say this one. That also I can do. So this is exclusively, you know, technology has made this possible. It was not there like 10, 20 years down the line, nobody could have thought of this. So in big, big libraries, people used to. So this is again value. So we go to different advocates and they say that you are corrupting our juniors. So all these features are available just to, you know, see where a particular case has been affirmed, where this has been relied. So again, this one is authority timeline. So authority timeline basically, so case map was giving me just the 20 cases. It gives me all the judgments. So all the 304 judgments where this was referred, where this was relied on, okay, where this was dissented. There are 2-3 cases where this was dissented also. There is Rajasthan High Court judgment. And if there are some cases where this was affirmed. So there are 2 Supreme Court judgments which has affirmed this case. So all the citing reference also you'll be able to see. So Supreme Court cases, major high courts and all the other cases. So timeline is given also. So this is citing reference. So what I request from you is just when next time you open Manupatra, go through all these and everything will be clear. So PDF format is available with or without case note. You can take out a printout from the source and given the code, the equivalent citations will be on the top of the judgment. Similarly, if you want to send a mail to a friend, to a colleague, anyone, just click on here. And if you need not, you know, go to your Gmail or anything, just everything will be available. It will go in attachments. Word format, if you want for drafting word format, sticky note, basically you can leave comments on this one. This is a upload it to Drive. If you want to save it in your Dropbox or your Google Drive, just sync it with this and you will be able to do that. If you want to save the document in our server, that also you can create folders. So, you know, you're working on a case in your firm. Now you go back to your home. If you wanted to access the same case, log on Manupatra and you will have this saved in my save documents from here. Okay. This is again very, very helpful. This is print replica. So we provide sources also. So there, these will be available as it's available in the judas. So this is the Supreme Court, basically the court copy of the judgment. We are providing the source of the judgment. So this also you can take out a printout. So sometimes publishers, what they're doing these days is they're changing the paragraphs for a particular judgment. That is creating a lot of problems, a lot of confusion in the courtroom. So here we don't do that and everything is available for you to see. So sometimes there's a spelling error in the source document also. So, you know, any confusion that you might have related to a judgment, you can always come here and check it from the source. So this is available in print replica. Similarly, other journals are also there. So this is as it is appearing in Uttaranchal cases, KLJ. So different copy of this case is available in the replica format from here. Okay. So this is one. Let's go to legal search. So this was for acts. I did for one act. You can always do it for two acts. Say I want CRPC 178 and NI 138. So that multiple sections you will be able to do your search on. Similarly, appellant respondent. So you just have a party name. So sometimes people do, you know, they just go to Manu search and type their party name. So what we suggest is go to legal search and go to, if you're searching for a party, just go to appellant respondent and make your search. So that way it will be searching only in the title. I will explain it to you. So Deep Singh, there is a judgment from Delhi High Court. You just write one party name or two party name. No need to write verses or anything. Just type the party name and make your search. So in whichever judgment, like the party was Jagdeep Singh, you'll be able to see from here. So now from the appellant respondent, it will only search in the title of the judgment. Okay. So Manu search searches the entire body of the judgment. From legal search, you can go to the specific searches. So if you just want to search the title, that you can do. If you similarly want to search in the case note, gender justice might not be there in the judgment, but our team might have put gender justice in the case note. That way it's very helpful. Subject wise, so any judgment that comes in Manupatra goes through this process that it is categorized in different subjects. So 50 subjects, we categorize them. So like intellectual property rights, I can select. So all the cases on intellectual property rights within a matter of seconds, you'll be able to see. You can cite them, cited most wise, newest. So whatever is happening in your particular field, you'll be able to be better. So case study is there. Date, if you just have a date of a judgment, sometimes you read in the newspaper that on this particular date, Delhi High Court passed the judgment. So now you just have this date of the judgment. So you can always select 1 October and you can make your search from here. Similarly, if you want to give a range for the search, also that you can do. Relevant section is for any judgment. Like, we also have this provision of, say, I'll use, say, let's go to the basics only. Say, can I? And 138. So the judgments which were based in NI 138, so we have segregated those for you. So this is a relevant section. So this particular case came out and it had these many sections, but actually this section was this particular judgment was based on only 2-3 sections. So we have segregated these two sections for you. So these are much more relevant to this. So that search is available from here, legal search relevant section. Similarly, citations are present. So all the Indian citations, we cover more than 325 journals. So all these journals are available. You can just select anyone. Say I am looking for a Supreme Court judgment. So no need to, you know, learn any format or anything. Just select the year, volume number. Oh, this doesn't have volume. Yeah. And you can make your page number. So page number 1. And from here, you will be able to get to the case from the equivalent citation. So all the major citations are covered with us. From legal search only, there is an option for act search. So one way to get to your bare acts is from table of contents. The second one is just come here and type CPC. It will ask you the code of civil procedure. If you want to view this in a single document, that you can do from here. Okay, so this is the entire act. If you want to take out a printout of this from here, that you can do. If you want to copy paste, that is fine. If I'm looking for a particular word, say review, in whichever section review word is coming, that also you will be able to see from here. These are some of the basic features in Manupatra that are most used. There are like many other features. There's legal analytics. There are some Boolean features that I will not. So we can have a different session on that one. So if there are any questions on this, I'd like to take. Okay, how do you find out? Arpit sir has said landmark cases. Okay, so to find landmark cases, there's one, like, use just justice and it will give you select relevant. So relevant is basically the landmark cases. Okay, so this is Vishakha is coming on the top. So once you have selected sorting by relevance, it will give you the landmark cases only. So Vishakha is the landmark case on gender justice. It will only give the judgments which are from Supreme Court or which are being quoted these days more. So that is a working definition for landmark cases. Just make your Manu search and select relevant. Okay, any other questions? Okay, perfect. So thank you for your time. This is Abhay. I hope you stay safe till this lockdown ends. And if there's any query related to Manupatra, you can always write to us on contact@manupatra.com. So similarly, if you want to send us any articles or anything, any suggestions regarding this, you can do that. Before signing off, I'll just show you. There's one more question, I guess. How do I research a paper? Okay, so research, if you're looking for judgments, you can use Manu search. Otherwise, there are like different reports that are available to you. There are articles that you can see from here. So you can read the articles from here. All the, if you're doing it on a particular subject, these all subjects wise data is available. So all the primary and secondary database is available here. You can use any one of these depending on your subject. Okay. So let's show you one small thing before signing off. So how to keep yourself updated through Manupatra, you know, small things which are done regularly are more important. So this is desktop alert. So you can always install this on your laptop or computer. So it will give you the relevant alerts that are coming every day. So you know it's not. And there's another option of Chrome alert. You can download this Chrome alert from here. Okay. And there's one more thing, is the newsletter. So newsroom, all the judgments are available from here. This is basically what is happening in the legal fraternity these days. So judgments, international cases, notifications, circulars, all these you will be able to see. Let's come to Manupatra and click on to this newsroom folder. Again, if you want to get an email in newsline, so this is just like a crisp summary of what's happening there. So every week we send you one of these. So just go ahead and put in your email ID and you will be able to. We also have a Telegram account, Manupatra Channel 7, if you search that. If you write to us on contact@manupatra, so we'll be able to send you the link for that particular channel. So you can get yourself subscribed in Telegram also. Okay, thank you for your time. This is Abhay signing off.